Hello everyone, and welcome here to part one of A Tale of Two Railways, where we are here at the Talyllyn Railway in Mid Wales, the very first reserved railway in the world, and we are here for the Bagley Bash. Yes, no steam engines for me, no sirree, I'm here all to see the diesels. So join me as we take a ride along the railway and see some very rare traction. Next, we take a ride behind number 12, St. Cadfan, up the line as far as Bryn Glas. Now, arguably, this possibly isn't the most scenic section of the line, but it was the first trip out of the day, certainly for me. We had number 9, Alf, who did an early morning run, but I decided a breakfast was needed first. So, join me as we take a nice sedate ride along the line. Next up, we have number 11, Tracorn, making the first of two solo trips along the line today. We aren't catching this particular train because I've elected to go on the second of the two journeys. Special shout out, Wolf. We have to go out, of course, here to the LMM team, of which you may spot them out in force today doing some recording. Lovely bunch of folks, and I can honestly say this trip would not have been so enjoyable had it not been for them. Here we are, taking a lovely little ride on Toby, the inspection trolley. Now, the audio for this, I have had to turn it down by about 20 decibels, and I cannot explain to you how incredibly loud this was, and in many ways, I'm glad we only went up to Pendray station, because as delightful as it is, you really do need earplugs if you're going to spend any time on this little inspection trolley. And for you Steam fans out there, you're not completely forgotten about. Here is Sir Hayden coming into Wharf Station from the shed at Pendray. They were running a service of steam trains in between the diesel, so your average visitor to the railway still had their steam fix. The entire day wasn't just given over to the passenger trains. A demonstration freight train was also run to show a critical part of this line in its heyday was to transport goods up to the people living in the hills doing the quarry work. Because of course, the roads weren't much more than dirt trails back in those days, and it wasn't just the slate coming down. You also needed provisions taken back up. Sadly, I don't have any footage of my own of our trip up the line with number 9 Alf. But here we see it making a runaround manoeuvre ahead of its journey back down. We won't be making that journey along with Alf because I have elected to wait here at the station for the double-headed train to come back, and that will be the last journey of the day. And here is the aforementioned double-headed train, led by number 11 with number 12 right behind, as they pass through Abergynolwyn. Now we have about a 30-minute break here, so able to grab some refreshments before this train returns and we jump on board. So on to our final clip of the day, which is of course number 9 Alf heading down the line to Towan Wharf. In the background you can see the living legend himself, Laurie Rose, who has reviewed Alf on his channel. So I'm going to post a link at the end of this video, you can go check that out for yourself. Very informative, very fun, I highly recommend it. So all too soon, we've come to the end of the day here at the Bagley Bash on the Talyllyn Railway. Now, if you've never been here before, like I hadn't before today, get down there. The weather was gorgeous. The staff and volunteers have been absolutely amazing. And there's so much more to see that I've purposely not shown you in this video. So stay tuned for part 2 of A Tale of Two Railways. And also, if you go and watch Laurie's video, just pop in his comments and say, Trains with Nick sent me. And with that said, thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye for now.